I still like the space. You know, the 5G rollout's been sort of well documented, but then you have the video game console upgrade cycle in 2020 as well. So I think that might tighten supply even further. And if you're talking about AMD, Intel, I'll do a little self would you rather here. I would rather AMD. You know, Intel has not been able to break out from those 2018 highs. And if you look at their revenue pie specifically, it's PCs, it's data centers, and they have big market share there, but they're losing it to companies like AMD, NVIDIA. There are new chips being introduced. There's cloud. So I would rather be in a company like AMD than Intel. I think Intel has to kind of run quickly to catch up here a little bit.
AMD certainly has the ability to take the fight to Intel based upon what's going on, and they're touting that their graphics chips are 18% faster. When you think about high-end cloud computing and the ultra-thin laptop world that's out there, this is a place that's very good for AMD. But you get back to Intel and you get back to a valuation that I can sleep with, and a company that to me is very well positioned across the entire space. I think if you really want to be conservative, I know it sounds crazy after the run, take a look at Taiwan Semi. I mean, this is the leader in essentially the white label chips for the entire industry, and I think these guys continue to see demand. We're getting updates in terms of where they see their current inventory status. It looks pretty good from here.